Welcome to Animal Adventures. Of Norwood, New Hampshire, and to actually learn about turtles and to actually watch a turtle being released and the importance of turtle conservation and of protecting the turtle's environment. We're here with Chris Bogart. Can you tell me about turtle rehabilitation and exactly your title and how you got to become rehabilitating turtles?
Well, wildlife rehabilitation is, you have to be licensed by the state to rehabilitate wild animals, any kind of wild animals. In New Hampshire, we are licensed by New Hampshire Fish and Game. And we also, in order to get our licenses, we have to be working with a veterinarian. We're not veterinarians. We don't have access to drugs that we may need sometimes for our animals, such as antibiotics. And of course, there are the unfortunate cases, animals that have to be euthanized. So someone that's rehabilitating wildlife, and in my case, I work exclusively with turtles, you have to be licensed by your state, and B, you have to be working with a veterinarian.
We have a snapping turtle, and we have one here that is being rehabilitated, and you'd be amazed at how a turtle can recoup. So first of all, tell me about the injuries of this turtle.
This turtle came to me, well, just to let you know, the reason I've got a blanket over her face is because she smells the spring air and she's very antsy and she just wants to go, she wants to take off, so covering her face like this calms her down a little bit. Mm-hmm. Anyway, this turtle came to me June of 2006. Some guy found her wandering around his front yard and he boxed her in for me, and I drove and picked her up. And I think that what initially happened was a car went over her to try to avoid hitting her. And in the process, she reared up. Turtles have a defensive mechanism, and it's more show than anything else. And what their defensive mechanism is, they rear up on the back of their legs. Well, I think when she felt the car going over her, she went into defense mode, and she reared up, and something on the bottom of the car scraped off the top of her shell. So when I got her, it was an old wound. It was quite large. A lot of the shell was literally caved in, and it was caught in some of her soft tissue. The wound did have a few maggots left. So I got her home, and of course I cleaned her up. But just to give you an idea of the size of the wound, it covered this.
So it covered here. Right?
Yes, this whole area. That whole area was all. It was all open. It was all there. There were some internal organs exposed. There was different kinds of tissue, muscle tissue, connective tissue exposed. So she had no shell left. And it's taken 2 years. When it first started healing and I saw nice new clean tissue, it all looked white like this. But as time goes on, this dark coloration is starting to move in. And I think that what that is, I think that is bone cell migration. I think this is the beginning of bone formation, and it's all going to fill in and it's all going to be dark. And when it does that and it thickens up, it's hard. It's so hard I can knock on it. That's when I'll be able to release her. However, right now it still is, see?
Yeah.
It's how soft it is. It's almost what I would call puncturable. So I've got to keep her, you know, until this hardens up. But the point being, with an injury like this, you know, some people could have run across her and given up on her and thought, man, she's never going to make it. But it's really pretty incredible. Like I said before, you know, the wounds that they can recuperate from. They're truly amazing animals. Well, this is an Eastern painted turtle, and they are a very highly aquatic species. And this particular turtle was brought to me last year, I believe it was in early July. She was attempting to nest, and she got nailed by a dog. This particular turtle, I think the dog had a hold of it for about a good half hour, 45 minutes. As you can see, she's lost a lot of her shell all the way around the bottom here, and you can clearly see the claw marks on the top of the shell. Those are claw marks and teeth marks. And just to, you know, give you an idea relative to what a normal shell looks like for a painted turtle, this is a normal looking shell. This is a shell that does not have any injuries on it, and you can really see the difference. You can see where she's lost, like I said, a lot of her outer shell right here, and of course, you know, the teeth marks and the claw marks become much more evident. Now, another thing that happened to her when she was being chewed on, this area on a turtle here, it connects the top shell with the bottom shell, and it's in between the front leg and the back leg. This is called a bridge. And so here, her bridge is fine. She has a bridge. Here, the dog chewed on her long enough, he completely eliminated her bridge. So when I got her, some of her internal organs were literally exposed. But as you can see, she really is healing beautifully.
What do you feed them? You want to keep it as natural their diet as possible.
You do want to keep their diet as natural as possible, but you have to look, at least personally, I look beyond that. And I'm thinking, okay, this is an injured animal, and they need to heal, and they need to mend wounds. And protein is a food that you want to feed that really helps facilitate the wound mending process. So I feed them a lot of protein, and which for these guys could be, it could be fish, it could be cooked chicken, it could be rodents. I do also offer them vegetation material. I offer them Reptamen, which is a manufactured food pellet, which is very well balanced. So in the beginning, when they're really needing to heal their wounds, I do offer them a lot of protein. It's a combination of protein and vegetation, primarily. He really wants to go back home, and that's what we're doing today, is we're releasing him back where he came from so he can continue his life out in the wild.
And we're here at, what pond is this?
I don't know the name of this stream, but it leads into Harvey Lake, and Harvey Lake, I'm sure, is part of his stomping grounds.
Well, he looks like he's raring to go. He says, yes, it's a nice, hot, beautiful day. Let's go.
Would make a conscious effort to keep an eye out for turtles from May to mid-July, and especially looking on the sides of the road. The turtle doesn't necessarily have to be in the middle of the road. By then, it may be too late, but if you see them on the side of the road, if you can safely pull over and stop and help that turtle across the road and move it in the direction that it's going, that could possibly save quite a few turtle lives.